While the table provides data on the percentile changes in exports per each type of goods over the same period of time, What happened? Hello, IELTS writers. Welcome to IELTS Juice. Let's start assessing a report today for IELTS Academic Module. The prompt says, the chart below shows the value of one country's exports in various categories during 2015 and 2016. As you can see, the IELTS doesn't say what type of chart it is. It is our responsibility to tell the IELTS what we see is a pie chart or a bar chart or a line graph. Maybe it's a table or visual or another visual like a diagram or a map. So this is our responsibility to tell the IELTS what it is. The table, okay, so we have another visual, shows the percentage change in each category of exports in 2016 compared with 2015. Okay, I actually, I did a sneak peek and this is a bar chart. So we have two visuals now. We have one bar chart and one table. Right now, I just want you to know that you can just devote one paragraph to each visual. That's a good strategy. That works for 70% of the visual of the tasks, of report tasks that we have. Anyway, let's continue. Another important point is that we have 2 years. So 2015, 2016. And the first thing that comes to my mind is that we are going to talk about all in past simple tense. Almost all in past simple tense. Now looking at the visual here, on the vertical axis, I have billions of dollars. So 60 here means $60 billion. And on the horizontal axis, we have product category, and I can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 categories: petroleum products, engineering goods, gems and jewelry, agricultural products, and textiles. What significant thing I can just by simply looking at the visual I can come up with is that in all years, except gems, in all categories except gems and jewelry, the second column, which is this light grayish color, is higher than the previous year, which is a darker gray, which is a darker shade of gray. So 2015 is this one, 2016 is the next year, and as you can see, in all categories, the second one is higher than the first one, except gems and jewelry. Moving on to the table, we only have percentage of change. So from 2015 and 2016, so that we usually, when we say compare, we compare the data first from 2016 with the data we had in 2015. And we have a percentage of change. So we say 3% increase, 8.5% increase. And as we just discussed, gems and jewelry changed for the amount of change was 5.18%, but it decreased. And the rest was all upwards. Another important thing, again, by looking at the table, I can pick up is that the highest number of change or the highest amount of change we have a number here. So the highest number for change is 15.24%, while the lowest was in agricultural products with 0.81%. Okay. Now, I came up with two, three significant points to remember. Now let's go into the actual report. The provided bar chart compares earnings generated from international sales of a nation. We accurately and correctly do not know the name of the nation, so we just need to say it's a nation, and that's fine. It's not a region, it's not a continent, it's not a district, it's a nation. In five categories in 2016. While the table provides data on the percentile changes in exports per each type of goods over the same period of time, what happened? Why is this sentence dangling? It's because of this semicolon, I guess. This should be a comma, not a semicolon. So I needed to read the previous sentence and then say, while the table provides data on the percentile changes in exports per each type of goods over the same period of time. You see how punctuation matters? This means that the sentence that comes after is all by itself an independent clause, meaning the message of the sentence is complete. But in this case, it's not. So I read it and I realized that, oops, we have a mistake. This is a punctuation mistake that affects grammar, that affects my understanding. So now we have an issue with our grammatical range and accuracy. Overall, an increase in all products except gems and jewelry is apparent. I wouldn't use the word apparent here. Apparent, I would use the word evident, and let me tell you why. Apparent has this meaning that yes, it is clear, I can see it, it's over there, but it's what I can see behind it, beneath it, on behind the curtains. There is something else going on. So, you know, for example, you go to work, you see everybody's there, you say hi, everybody says hi, and then you notice that, for instance, currently he is sick. And you talk to other colleagues and say, hey guys, where's Adam? And they say, well, I don't know, we made a phone call and he responded with a text message telling us that he is not joining us today. Apparently, he is sick. So, he may sound like a sick person, he may say he is sick, but he might not be sick and he is just tired, or he drank too much alcohol the night before, so he's hungover for whatever reason. Apparently, he is sick. But if you actually make a video call or you go there to pay him a visit and you see that he is actually not feeling good and he's coughing and he has a fever or he has a temperature, then you say, no, I mean, it's evident that he is sick. Now you can see that it is clearly there. Anyway, I'm not going to teach you about vocabulary, but what I'm going to tell you is that I wouldn't use this word because this word is not a perfect fit here. It's not wrong, but this is not the word we wanted to see here in a report. In a report, you actually see there is nothing that we need to understand. This is not our place to do so. And in IELTS reports, whatever you see, you will report it. The top two exports, which were petroleum goods and engineered products. So let's see. The top two exports. Yes. These two were the top two exports. Petroleum products and engineered goods. Very good. Had similar sales volumes. Oh, that's a very good, actually, topic sentence for this paragraph. So I'm now going to read about the two top exports here. And interestingly, they had similar sales volumes. How much? I don't know. Details must be in the sentences within the paragraph. And I am now curious to know what the details are. Oil-based products, means petroleum products, increased slightly by 3%. You can see 3 is written as T-H-R-E-E, And percent is fine. If you make it all one word or two words, per cent or percent, it's fine. From around $60 billion US dollars in 2015 to, I love the word around, to roughly $62 billion US dollars in 2016. Let me check. From around 60, correct? That's my, that might be 60 point something, to 62. Again, imagine this line is 65, so it's definitely below 64 and 63. So 62 is a very good estimate. $62 billion US dollars in 2016. Very good. Engineered goods increased at a higher rate of 8.5% from approximately $57 billion US dollars to roughly $62 billion. Good. So this one, yes. You see, 8.5% change, and then from 57 makes sense to 62 makes sense. Very good. Very good. Roughly. You guys take a look at this. Roughly. Approximately. Another roughly, which is okay, and around. You can also use the word in the vicinity of or about. You see, we call these words approximately, roughly, about, in the vicinity of, around. Sometimes you can use nearly. We call them vague language, V-A-G-U-E, language. Vague language or unclear language, but in a very good term, in a positive way, not unclear in a bad way. No, it's unclear because it is really unclear. I mean, I don't have the exact data here. I don't have an exact number. Is it 57.5 or 57.9 or 56.9? I don't know. I really don't know. That information is not given, which is not what you may experience in tables. In tables, you have the exact number. You have 5.18. Very, very accurate. So this paragraph is actually a very good sample for us to learn vague language. And vague language will help us improve our accuracy. Be mindful of that. This is a very important one. If I were you, I would check this paragraph again and I would take notes of the vocabulary used here. This simple paragraph has a lot to teach us. Let's move on to the next paragraph. The other three categories had significantly lower earnings. I'm just in love with this. Let's look at the coherence and cohesion column. Now, what we see is that in the first paragraph, we focused on the two top exports. And in the second paragraph, we are going to talk about the other three, the remaining ones. You see how beautiful it is? I see the logic now in writing the report. The writer decided that these two categories must be reported in one paragraph and also mentioned the data from the table. And now we're going to talk about the rest. You see, this also shows me the power of vocabulary, because when you say the rest, it's like, yeah, the other. These are the two important ones and the rest. And the rest is like not as important, but yet we are still going to talk about them. With precious stones, beautiful. We don't have to actually paraphrase the data given to us. So instead of gems and jewelry, you don't have to change it. Instead of engineered goods, you don't have to say manufactured goods. In many cases, if you just stick to what's written, you will be fine. But in this particular case, gem is paraphrased so beautifully that I'm, I, I, I'm thrilled. I'm really happy. I'm really excited to read. The vocabulary range is shown here. The power of vocabulary is shown to us. And at the same time, it is accurate. That requires some skills. And jewelry being the only type that experienced a decline by just over 5%. Just over. You see, it was 5.18. Another correct use of vague language. From about $43 billion in 2015 to the estimated $41 billion. I wouldn't use the word estimated here. Again, I understand it has the meaning that you predicted it and this was around, but not here, because it is mostly used for future sentences and we already know what happened. It's all past. Instead of 41 billion in, you could say slightly over 40 billion US dollars. That would help us write this sentence more accurately. Farming products, again, agricultural products, were approximately 30 billion US dollars in 2015 and generated only a slightly higher turnover, another correct use of vague language, in 2016, 0.8% increase. You see how well the parentheses are used? The information is in a pair of parentheses. And it means I am giving you the data. The number is not that significant, but if you are interested, here is the number. If you wish to read this part, go ahead and read it. If you want to ignore it, go ahead and you can ignore it. It doesn't affect your understanding of the report. That requires skill. Another problem with comma, this shouldn't be a semicolon, this must be comma. Whereas cloth goods, textile, saw the past simple, saw the most significant jump is an accurately used word here because it actually jumped. We're talking about 15.24%. That's the highest number of change. Over 15% from around 26 billion US dollars to 31 billion US dollars. That's 236 words. And as expected, guys, this is the band descriptors, and it's clear. In task achievement, this is a perfect 9. This is just perfect. Everything was reported, and it was reported in with comparison. The table and the visual given, which was a bar chart, were in connection. In coherence and cohesion, we have another perfect organization. I totally understood the logic. We talked about the first top ones in the first body paragraph, and there was a second body paragraph above that. We didn't have a conclusion, which is an issue if you want to get an 8 and higher, 8 or 9 in coherence and cohesion. So for that, we just stop at 7. For vocabulary and grammar, you saw the range. You saw how powerful the words were used. There were errors, of course, errors in the advanced use of words, but we also had only two very, very occasional errors in punctuation. There were errors, not inappropriate. We didn't have any inappropriate grammatical structures. We had only two errors. And even if we had three or four with this type of error, it would still stay at 8. I mean, all in all, what do you expect? This is a healthy 8. Could it be improved? Yes, it's not that far away from 8.5. Not that far away from 8.5. It's just a pity that we needed more accuracy and more control, specifically about the punctuation and vocabulary. All in all, I absolutely enjoyed reading this report with you guys and assessing it. I hope you did as well. And until next time, remember, your report, your letters, or your essays will be your representatives. So one way or another, we have to make sure that they do their jobs well. Until next time, I wish you a lovely day ahead.